Have you been enjoying meeting your massive army of fans today?
I was thrilled to see so many people show up. I thought, well, you know, maybe only 20 people will come or something, and instead we had all of these hundreds, so it's been fantastic.
The books, of course, have just exploded worldwide, and we're so excited to be getting our first film installment. I guess taking it right back to the beginning, though, what inspired you to tell this wonderful story?
I was almost about to get a tattoo when I was in New York, and I held off, but I had this whole idea about a magical race of warriors who use tattoos as their sort of way of fighting demons and utilizing magic, and it just exploded into this idea of a secret magical world in New York City, and it grew from there.
Of course, I mean, that world is populated by so many fantastic characters. Fans, of course, have their favorites. I mean, who for you is the most special? Who means the most to you?
Probably Clary's best friend, Simon, is based a bit on sort of my best friend and, you know, my boyfriend at the time, my husband now. And so means the most to me as a person, but the characters all mean something to me in different ways.
Of course, the fantasy genre, I think, is just so vastly popular and beloved, especially by fans here today. What do you think people get from that they don't get from other genres of fiction and drama?
Well, I think there's a richness to it of adventure, and, you know, your head's just in the clouds when you're dreaming of worlds like, you know, Westeros and, you know, things like, and it brings a sense of sort of magic and, you know, spectacularness to the ordinary and mundane. And I think there's something wonderful about that.
Of wonderful. We've had our first little glimpses of the upcoming film adaptation. I mean, how does it feel for you to see this wonderful world you've created realized on the big screen?
You know, that was the first time I've seen it, that bit. I mean, I've seen other bits of the movie, but not that part. And it really is amazing, you know, just to see my characters sort of come to life and interact with each other. I mean, it's sort of a dream come true.
Of course, I mean, a wonderful young cast. How pleased were you with that, and how close are they to what you had in mind when you were writing?
They're very close because I was pretty involved in the casting, so I was able to, you know, put in votes for some of the characters, and it was lovely to see people, you know, cheer the characters as they come on, you know. I mean, Jamie is obviously a fantastic Chase, and Clary is, and Lily is a wonderful Clary. It was great to see people sort of cheer for Robbie, Sheehan as Simon, and they really do embody their characters perfectly.
In terms of adapting, obviously you've been very involved in that process. Are there any major changes you've had to make, or was it quite easy to take the world of the off the page and put it on screen?
There were major changes they had to make, because when you're writing, you have sort of an unlimited budget of imagination. You can put anything in, but when you're making a movie, you can't, you know, blow up the whole city, that kind of thing, without spending a lot of money. So there were changes that had to be made for budgetary reasons and to make the movie shorter, but as long as they stayed true to the spirit of the book, I was generally okay with it.
Are there any particular scenes, either in this first book or in the books yet to be realized on screen, that you're especially excited to get a chance for people to see in this way?
I was really excited to have everyone get to see the party that Magnus Bane, who's this, you know, fabulous warlock character, throws. And they really did realize it beautifully, you know. It's just a fantastic array of different kinds of creatures, of, you know, mermaids and fairies and banshees and warlocks and vampires and werewolves all in one place, just kind of having drinks and hanging out. And it's a really fun scene.
Bring it back to today, when you've been meeting fans, what kind of things have they been saying to you? What kind of stories and their experience of the book? Is there anything that surprised you, amused you, or meant a lot to you?
Usually that they cried. And it always means a lot to me, even though it sounds a bit sadistic when somebody says that they cried when they read your book, because it means that they care and they're invested and they believe these characters, and the characters mean something to them. So even when they say, you know, I cried and cried and cried, it kind of makes me happy.
Is there a book or a story that's meant that much to you?
Lord of the Rings, actually. The first time I read it when I was just a kid, and I really, you know, felt for the characters, and it was the first time I'd really been immersed in a fantasy world like that, and I cried for them. So definitely that one.
Fans will want to know, are you working on anything at the moment? What's coming up next?
I'm finishing the last book in the series of The Mortal Instrument. So it's really interesting to see the first book become a movie just as I finished the last one.
That process, obviously, that it's kind of overlapping a little bit. Has that influenced you in any way? Has seeing things on screen kind of slightly influenced how you're feeling about what you're writing at the moment?
I try not to let it too much, but I have to admit that sometimes now when I'm writing the characters, I do, you know, I see them with the faces of the actors, and I'm like, oh, you know. I mean, they're lovely faces, so you can't complain.
Talking of lovely faces, Lily, I mean, such a talented young actress. I mean, what do you think made her right for your leading lady?
I think she has an amazing blend of vulnerability and strength. She can project this, you know, ability to be hurt and yet also at the same time project this, you know, sort of immense bravery. And I think that when you get both of those together, that's rare quality.
I guess fans around the world watching this are going to want to know, do you have a message for them? Is there anything you'd like to say to all those people out there who love these books so much?
I just want to say thank you so much for coming on this journey with me. It's been six books of a massive world of characters and, you know, their adventures, their loves, and their, you know, despair and their happiness. And I really appreciate people being so committed to the books, and I hope that they will love the movie.
This sixth book, is this going to be the final book? Is that absolutely the last time you're delving into this world?
It might not be the last time I'm delving into this world, but it's the end of the story of these characters. So I have to say goodbye to them, and it's very sad.
I mean, fans will want to know, although I'm sure you can't tell us too much, is there anything you can tell us about what we can expect from that final chapter?
From the last book of the series? I think I can say that we're going to go to a place that's been described in the books, but we've never seen it. But we'll finally see it.
Of the book, you know what that means.
Yes.
Thank you so much for talking to us, and enjoy the rest of your time.
Thank you so much for having me here.